Hello, Collective. Welcome back to the platform. Thank you for watching as always. Please remember to like, comment, share, subscribe to the YouTube channel. You are greatly appreciated for watching the Ascended Divination Priestess channel. I am sending you all lots of love, joy, peace, and happiness. Many, many blessings to you and your families as always. I return to source. I return to sender. All negative energies and intent immediately and permanently. I call in only the purest of white light and pray that you stay only in the highest of vibrational energy. Whatever the enemy has stolen from you, it is returned to you. All evil and negative plans of the enemies against you are dismantled and being dismantled as we speak. As I have said, so shall it be. Judgment is final. Okay, so I think what this is that we have a King of Pentacles behind the scenes that's going through some type of transition in life. It's that someone has been living a very toxic lifestyle for a long time. Someone has been unable to make some type of change in his life due to the types of people that have been around him. This is a man that has been around people that have been manipulating him. Someone is a little bit on the, not a little bit, someone is on the manipulative side. So it's like someone is going from the dark to the light. Someone has been very toxic and karmic their whole life, and now they're going through some type of transition in their life, learning how to live in their truth. Now, there's something I picked up on this man where it's like, this is someone that's finding the strength to heal, because this is someone that's, there's something that's very difficult for him to do, and this has to do with his childhood. Someone may have came from a very toxic childhood where his father was toxic, like everybody in the community, in the family was toxic. So he probably more than likely didn't see anything wrong with how he was before, because this is someone going through a transition, right? But someone has found their strength to embark on their healing journey, may see you as wish fulfillment, maybe wanting to get married to you, with you, whatever it is, and wants to have success and victory with you. So someone is planning on coming to you to balance things out, may want to extend some type of friendship to you, and planning to what, establish themselves with you. They see you as an Empress energy, but there's something with this man where it's that he's burdened because he may have taken some type of action behind the scenes. He was like misusing his power before, so he may have taken some type of impulsive action to cause you some type of hindrance, may have told some type of lied on you, gossip about you, or something like that. He's also worried about a King of Swords coming towards you to give you some type of offer. This King of Swords may have easier access to you to tell you the truth about some type of situation that's been going on. Both of these masculines are watching you. Queen of Cups, they see you as very genuine. They may both want to apologize to you, or maybe the King of Swords is just coming towards you with some type of communication that's going to cause a tower but lead to a new beginning for you and balance things out. There may be something going on in the court system that you are not aware of. Maybe one of these masculines are going through a divorce, or there may be a case that comes up that's going to have to do with defamation, because there's something I've been picking up on where a group of people have been doing a lot of lying and self-sabotaging. Something I'm also picking up on this King of Pentacles that I got this download about is this is someone that self-sabotages a lot, but is trying to heal his mindset, trying to see things from a higher perspective, trying to distance himself from a very karmic community, karmic family, karmic relationship. There's something like that going on. Someone is starting to listen to their intuition, starting to self-actualize, right? Introspect and things like that. So whereas this man used to move on impulse, was very impulsive with the things he did, now he's starting to use foresight and thinking before he moved. Someone is trying to wait as well for the right time on when to come towards you to give you some type of offer. When that time comes, he will be traveling towards you because someone has decided to advocate and work with you or something like that. But there's something about this man's mental where it's like, he keeps going back and forth. Is that one day he wants to be genuine with you. He wants to work with you. He sees you as like a possible lover, soulmate, whatever this is, twin flame. I don't know what this is. But then the next moment he's stuck in his mind wanting to control you, wanting to trap you. And that's not going to work, because if you're someone who's a healer, a true Queen of Pentacles, that does not work. It's that things like that will agitate you, because you're going to see this man right at the door where his true intentions are. So if at the door he's coming with this energy, you're going to see the truth right through him. So someone, it's like he's been coming up with different tactics on how he can come into your energy. And until this person chooses to self-actualize and do the right thing, he's not allowed around you. It's what your ancestors is telling me. he's not allowed around you. So he's going to have to make some type of change and let go of the lying, let go of the toxicity, let go of the karmic way of living. Someone is very toxic. I don't know if this is a man that likes to have options, something like that. But someone has been in the dark. This may even be someone that does a lot of mental manipulations, does a lot of wordplay. Someone has been manipulating people his whole life, and he's been able to get away with that, but he's not able to do that with you. So if he comes towards you, okay, he's been in his devilish energy his whole life. He's going to come out. He's going to have to come towards you with the Ace of Swords kind of energy. Look, I need you to be straightforward with me and tell me the truth. I don't got time for your BS. You already know I see through you with this Queen of Pentacles energy. You already know I'm connected to Source. I know exactly what it is. I have a lot of common sense. So if two and two ain't adding up, I don't got time to be wasting with you. I need to go by Monday. I got my family to take care of, my husband to go pay attention to. I got my children to take care of. I got my, you know, whatever it is she has going on to go and take care of. So there's something where this man, I don't know if he's reminiscing or thinking something over. It's like he's trying to remember or figure out, or is realizing why it is you left some type of institution. And this is because people were plotting on you. People were trying to end you. It's also something that I'm hearing where it's that he's coming to you to tell you the truth about what an institution was planning for you. They were planning to end you, take you out. I don't know if this had to do with a life insurance policy. I don't know if this had to do with you and him not being allowed to come together. Whatever this is. But he's coming towards you to tell you the truth. And this man is living with a lot of anxiety because he does want to have ultimate fulfillment with you. But you may not really be paying attention to any of this stuff because you're more focused on your life, what you have going on in your immediate proximity, right? You're not worried about what's going on outside of you. It has nothing to do with you. Your immediate obligations is what matters to you. This whole family, he's learning that they collaborated to cause you some type of betrayal, both of you some type of betrayal, so that this union won't come together. They've been working on keeping him trapped in his mind about you, telling him that you're very toxic, karmic, into voodoo, into dark magic, and all of that. They've told him a lot of lies, but now that he knows the truth and he's getting out of his mind about that, he's putting into this chapter, maybe coming towards you to have some type of closure, because there's something maybe he doesn't understand, or maybe something you don't know. And once you two have this closure and put an end to this karmic cycle, right, you can have a new beginning together. Someone may want to commit to you, but they are afraid that you're going to be what, standoffish towards them, because you know exactly what it is they were saying about you behind the scenes. They're seeing you as like a Queen of Swords, High Priestess energy right now. That's just kind of focused on getting to your destination and mastering yourself. They also know that you're someone very intuitive as well. You may have intuitively known that this was your twin flame, but he didn't know. But because he's going through some type of awakening, now he's starting to realize that, hey, that's my twin flame. I guess I kind of made the wrong decision by choosing someone else. So this man may be looking a little deeper into something, and now he knows the truth, or he was looking into something a little deeper, self-actualizing. Maybe he started to embrace his spiritual side. Someone may be going through some type of change, like I mentioned earlier, and he's getting in touch with his spiritual side, which is awakening him to a different aspect of life, right? Someone knows now that you are an actual Queen of Cups, and this has him burdened, because now that he knows you're an actual Queen of Cups, Empress energy, this means also that there are people around him that know. There could be another person that's in competition with him to come towards you. This could be like a King of Swords that may be trying to block him from coming towards you. Whatever it is, the truth is going to come out regardless. What there is a source out here, like, people know the truth about you, whereas people used to believe that you were dark, you were a liar, you were manipulative, you were a narcissist, like very egocentric and things like that. It's coming out that you're just someone very humble and minding your business. And then the person that was lying on you, they're being found out to be, what, a liar. Someone has been lying that they're someone's twin flame. They've been doing rituals behind the scenes. Someone is very vindictive, very conniving, manipulative. And this is how they've always been able to get things to go their way. Someone goes to like a high priestess, like they work with a high priestess to make sure things go in their way. So this could be someone that even pretends to be gifted and things like that. I know I've been picking up a lot on that energy for a while, but someone could be out here pretending to be gifted. Gosh darn it. There, the Ten of Swords, this is so funny. The Ten of Swords has to do with someone receiving advice from a false religious energy. And then here it is, like a false Hierophant. And then here it is, we have the Hierophant coming right after the Ten of Swords. That is freaking hilarious as heck spiritually. So whatever this is like they're coming towards you to tell you that, hey, I only did what I did because, you know, someone told me that you were this. Someone told me you were a liar. Someone told me you were reckless. Someone told me you were loose. Someone told me you were this, that you wouldn't be a good option to get with. Someone told me that you were a gold digger. Someone told me you were pregnant. Someone told me you were married. Someone told me you were ticking. You dated a lot of, like, they told this person a whole lot. A whole lot. But instead of him now listening to these people, he's taking charge of his life and deciding to end this chapter. Or there could be someone in a community that's a higher up that's choosing to put an end to this karmic cycle so that this man can move on and go for what it is that he wants. Or he may have gone to an actual Hierophant, like someone in his community that he reveres, or someone outside of this community, like a priest or something, to ask them for the truth. And they're telling him something about another energy behind the scenes. This came out in the reverse, which means that whoever he went with is absolutely a nightmare. They are a false character, unhinged. He may need to go as well to go get help with his mental, his emotions, because this is like a King of Pentacles that's out of touch with his emotions. Someone is strictly mental. I remember there was a man that I used to work with not even a long time ago, but I worked with this man before, and this is when I was still going through like my awakening. But even during that time, I could still tell when people operated from their heart space. But when I tell you, this man sat by me because I had develop like an ability where when I sit around people, I can tell like where, which space like they're acting from. Is it from their heart or their mind? When I said this man's heart was like, it wasn't there. Like I didn't feel anything. It wasn't there. If he has a heart, like it's just a physical vessel. So there's something where it's like this King of Pentacles has always operated with his mental and left like the emotional side of his life to just kind of fall down by the roadside, like neglected that part of him, right? So now there's something where it's like he's been advised to put an end to him being a false person, pretending to be in the upright, but the whole time he's dark, like morals, likes ethics, does not operate by ethics. And they're telling him, if you want to go towards someone, if you want to work towards someone, you're going to have to be in the upright. You can't go to this person giving them, feeding them nonsense. You can't go towards them with hokey pokies. You're going to have to live in your truth. Because this is someone I picked up on has been coming up with a lot of different tactics on how he can come towards a feminine energy to get her to let her guard down so that he can overpower her and have the advantage over her. And you know, when a man thinks that way, that means he does not have any pure intent for you. There's some type of ulterior motive for why he's coming towards you. And it's usually to sabotage you. Okay. Now, there's another woman, I don't know if this is someone he partnered up with, that is planning some type of attack because she wants to make sure that you and this man does not get together. He may know the truth about this woman by now, or maybe he's choosing to live in denial. Nobody cares about that. That's his business. You gotta let some people figure things out the hard way. So whenever he's meant to learn the lesson that he's supposed to learn because of her, he'll learn the lesson. So I don't even think you're worried about that, because I see you focusing on your new beginning, focusing on your truth, focusing on, you know, perfecting yourself, living in your truth, embracing yourself, taking charge of life, grabbing that bull by the horn. Like, you're focused on your pentacles and things like that. And I don't think you care what this institution has going on, what this Hierophant or whoever has going on, what the devil has. You don't care about none of that. Like, you're literally focused on your life, on your environment, your world around you is what you care about, okay? There's something where it's like he wants to come in and tell you the truth so that you two can sail on the calmer water, because he wants to have some type of fulfillment with you. But this man, he is still out here being very defensive. Don't want to hear, this is someone that lives in denial. The Nile is a river in Egypt. I don't think you are in Egypt. Someone is out here refusing to take accountability for their actions in a situation. This is someone that was trying to destroy your stability, your foundation, so that he could come in and save the day. Captain, save a ho-ho-ho day. But the only thing is that, who are you saving the day from? Remember, sir, it's you. So you cause destruction in someone's life, but you want to come in and not take any type of accountabilities. You want to come in and tell lies and things like that, and then you and who are going to sail onto calmer waters. You're BSing yourself. You need to calm down because that ain't how that works, okay? You're going to have to come in and tell the truth. You're going to have to come in and own up to what it is that you did. It's what I'm being told to tell you, because this woman right here, the Queen of Pentacles, they're no nonsense people. Yeah, they're down to earth. Yeah, they see things from different perspectives. You can talk to them. You can come from any walks of life and talk to the Queen of Pentacles, and she will understand what it is you're saying, where you're coming from. Now, that does not mean that you are able to manipulate her and get her to believe what it is you're telling her if she knows it's a lie. But this is someone with the ability to see things from multiple different perspectives. So when you come to her and you talk to her, whether it's in truth or in lie, she's going to see exactly what it is you're doing, what your motives are, may even know what it is you're about to tell her before you let it come out of your mouth. But if you come towards this woman with a lie, you're going to get your feeling hurt, because she's not even going to entertain your nonsense for 3 seconds. She said you got about 2 seconds to start talking. If you feed me any nonsense, goodbye. Okay? There's a group out here, whoever this, wherever this community is, group of friends, families, colleagues that he's coming from, they're all fighting behind the scenes, going through a lot of heartache. People may be crying behind the scenes because they've worked so hard to make sure that this man does not come towards you. They're burdened. I'm telling you, these people are burdened and weighed down behind the scenes, because what I just heard is that they didn't know he was looking into something. There was an investigation going on the whole time, and they didn't know that this man was looking into it. Like, this is something where it's like a bunch of people were going in and telling him a bunch of lies about you. But now he has gone from living in the dark about you to knowing the truth about you. This is why now you are able to move on with your life. So whatever plots they were planning and things like that, it's not coming into fruition. It's done. You could even have a Queen of Pentacles reverse. Someone in the dark behind the scenes that's headed right to poverty. She's leaving a community to go and plot someone's ending with a Hierophant, because she wants to deter you from being able to defend yourself, deter you from being able to move on. She says she don't want you to be able to move on. She don't want you to be strong out here. She don't want you to be seen as someone in the upright. So this is a woman that's intimidated by another woman. You're going to move on with your life, collective, and she's going to have to move on. If she's not careful, you're going to end up in prison at your age. You may want to calm down, because whatever it is you think that's about to happen, it's not happening. I'm telling you. Whoever you're coming after, they're still manifesting a new beginning. Someone will be seeing. Someone's coming out of the cold, will be living a sufficient, self-sufficient life, independent, content, and fulfilled in life. Very humble about it as well. So I don't know what it is you think you're about to manifest. You ain't manifesting nothing but endings and for yourself. I'm telling you, there's an Empress that's about to pass away. This could be someone's mother, someone's wife. Hello. Someone's about to pass away. So whatever it is you're planning on doing, you may hold back. I know you're trying to control someone's finances. You may be trying to control a feminine's energy finances. I don't know how you have access to someone's finances that you should not. You're about to end up in some type of legal case, legal court, legal proceedings that's going to deplete you of all your resources. So if you have a little bit of money, you may want to save that instead of going and paying people to block someone's new beginning, because they're still going to have it and it's coming in quickly. And this is going to balance things out for them, because they stay committed to what having this new beginning. This is their justice. This is a high priestess that knows that you are trying to cause them a tower. There's a high priestess as well that you may not be aware of, that knows that you are trying to do something to someone else. And there's a Queen of Cups in here that you all keep trying to come after. She may be trying, you are trying to come after, and she may be trying to just disregard you all. However, there's also another Queen of Cups in the reverse that's wanting to send some type of communication that she thinks is going to defeat, I don't know, a King of Wands or whoever this is. You may want to throw it with caution, because right now there are people around you all that are sick and tired of you all. And I don't know if you all know that. People are about sick and tired of all of you. I see 4 women that just don't know when to let go. They're tired of you all. They're out here trying to make sure that someone does not come in and give you an offer. They said before he can take any initiative, before he can take any steps, make any plans to go and balance something out with this star seed, this Earth Angel and give them a marriage proposal. We're going to end them. So before he even takes any action, let's go ahead and do this. Baby, guess what? It's a disappointment. This is the end of the road for you. Again, someone's about to pass away. Baby, someone's mother, someone's wife. I don't know what this is, but you're about to be gone. You're going back to the dream world. Okay? You're about to go back to the dream world because the spirit realm said, you know what? We've been patient with you long enough and we've told you these two are coming together, or this person is going to be abundant in life. And you're still in listening. You want to be out here playing God. So someone is about to go back to the spirit realm. And we don't feel no ways about it. We don't feel sorry for you, nothing, because you put yourself in that boat. You put yourself in that boat. Okay? This whole community collaborating with each other. This came out sideways, this King of Pentacles. I knew this had to do with a King of Pentacles. This is someone in the reverse. This is someone in the reverse. Someone wants to be in like a traditional marriage, but he's not stable enough to be in a traditional marriage. Someone does everything because of greed. And he needs to go to therapy. I don't know if you're going to like a hierophant to get advice. You need to go to an actual psychiatrist. Plus that hierophant, hopefully they're in the upright. But you need to go to a psychiatrist, a counselor, mental health personnel to help you with your mental and your emotions. Because there's something that's not stable about your emotional, your internal state of being is out of balance. You have been out here determined to take someone down that has done nothing to you. And just because you want to come in and balance something out does not mean they have to end up with you. People have free will to decide what it is that they want in life. People have free will to decide who they want to be with, what they want to do in life, what they want to invest in, their options. This is why we are multifaceted. We are always coming up with new ideas and things like that. This is why we're abundant and things like that. With the kind of energy you're trying to cause distress to. There's I don't know if this is your wife, your mother, or whoever this is that's trying to plot someone's ending. You may want to tell her to sit down because she's about to pass away and focus on her healing. I mean, she ain't healing. She's going back home. But she may want to use the rest of her time that she has here wisely, because some type of action she wants to take to cause someone some type of mental imprisonment or bring some type of legal issues to someone is going to have her way down, because she don't want someone having some type of abundance. So they're taking actions behind the scenes to cause someone an ending. It's about to have her way down. Way down in a way she could never have predicted. She is absolutely passing away. So I don't know if this is like a heart magic she's sending, heart spells and things like that, rituals that she's doing. It's about to have her going into that dark night of the soul she will not be returning from. Like someone is transitioning to the spirit realm actively. Okay? Karma. We don't feel no ways about it. At all. I don't know if this is your mother, your wife, baby mama, or whoever someone else is. Yeah. I can't help you. Yeah, I can't help you. Now he sees the truth about the woman that he chose. It's like, she's been plotting to take me out. She's been having relations with a King of Swords. She's been doing this, doing that. Sir, that's your business. Witch is telling you, when you come towards this Queen of Pentacles that's minding their business, come with the truth, because they don't got time for your nonsense. Anyways, what is this Queen of Wands plotting? Oh, how to sabotage someone's livelihood. How to sabotage someone's image. How to sabotage a relationship. Two people coming together. Yeah, that's cute. That's cute. And listen, she's planning on coming towards another woman to give them a piece of her mind. She said, you know what? I'm going to go in there and I'm going to give her a piece of my mind. I'm going to tell her something, and it's going to have her trapped in her mind and weighed down about who this person is and how my family can cause blockages in her life and keep her from receiving any type of offers, and she cannot have this and blah, 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 blah. He got married to me. I defeated her. I'm stronger than her. I work better and harder than her. Girl, you better sit down back. You better sit down, girl. Your brain circuit is way too short. You need to cut it. Your body got too many miles on it. You need to cut it. And I'm telling you, cut it. Trying to end someone's investments. Trying to end someone's strength. Forward movement. New beginning. Their energy. You can copy this energy, because this is not your energy. You're under judgment. You and your friends are under judgment, and you're about to be going through financial like for trying to cause someone else financial like, trying to block someone's dream. You need to go seek mental help. Go and seek mental help. Now, what is she? You're planning on going to do something. What are you going to go do? Because this is what I want to know. What are you about to go do, girlfriend? That's what we want to know. He's thinking. He said, what is this heifer about to go do? That's what this King of Pentacles reverse wants to figure out. He said, what is she about to go and do? She's about to go collaborate with a group of people to make sure things go in her favor. And he's trying to figure out what you are up to as well, collective. He said, what is this woman up to? I need to know what she's doing so I can hinder her. I can block her. I can stop her forward movement. Okay? This woman, this Queen of Wands that's not in the upright, because remember we have the Seven of Swords reversed right over her. She's not in the upright. She's wanting to travel to a community and get them to help her block someone else's work, interfere with justice, and she's weighed down because, honey, it's still going to be balanced out. It's like no matter what she does, that the universe is all over it. It's like, you know what, girl? You undo it, we fix it. You break it, we put it back together. I'm telling you, she's gonna go to a couple or a community to go gossip. Because she needs to have people see you as less than. She needs people to see her as better than you. So she's going to go spread gossip. That's all she's going to go do. And she's going to go partner up with a King of Pentacles that does the same thing. Gossip. Does nothing but gossip. Guess what? When she gets to the community, they don't want nothing to do with her because they already know who she is. You're rejected before you even get there. Baby. You got several seats to take, and you need to take them immediately. You leaving your foundation or your home to go lie and gossip about someone in a whole different community. You definitely got mental illness. You having your new beginning, collective, and they know it. She knows it. You know it. Everybody know it. You care a little bit too much about someone else's life. They don't care about you and paying you no mind. Nothing. You are trying to block someone from being seen. You said, if they are seen, I'm going to lose my mind. I'm the one that's been doing the real work. This is me. I'm the actual empress. I need them to choose me so I can have victory over her. And I can live this Ten of Pentacles lifestyle that I didn't deserve. Girl, guess what? You and your family about to be out here struggling. You're going to have to return back to where you came from and figure it out, because it's the end of the road for you. Any new beginnings you're having, baby, it ain't going nowhere. It's a difficult one. Okay? So you can keep lying about this offer. She said, I'm going to go to her and tell her, listen, he gave me the offer, so this competition is over. And you're going to look at her like there was a competition. I didn't know there was a competition. What was the competition for? Oh, being a high priestess, girl. Listen. The universe is taking care of us over here. We don't got nothing to worry about. So you can keep stealing, keep lying, keep doing your voodoo. I'm even messing up my slogan. You can keep doing your voodoo. He do, she do, quote, do, they do, we don't do over here to get what it is you want. We know exactly how you got to where you are. You got to it on your back and on your knees. Shaking that ASS for Drake. Hands on your knees. Drake said, shake that ASS for him. Okay? Go do more witchcraft. Go do more voodoo. Go cause more illusions. Okay? Don't go lying on that man of high honor because he don't want to be with you no more. Girl, he don't realize you ain't about nothing. So he's going to go away and give that offer to someone else. There's something about the justice system balancing something out that has to do with a financial payout. Whatever belongs to you, collective, is being protected. It comes with love and money. Look at that. You get it both. And they're going for it to give you this offer. And you know what this family has been doing. This group of friends and families, all their rituals and having some type of truth being blocked, stopped, and everything. They said, no. If they come together, she's going to be abundant. She's going to be happy in life. She cannot be happy. I deserve the happiness. I deserve the fulfillment. I'm the real empress, girl. You keep saying you're the real empress, and people just keep looking at you like the buffoon that you are, because they know you ain't no real empress. You know you ain't no real empress either. Like, you coming out here with the devil and the seven of swords in the reverse above you. Girl, stop it. Stop lying about someone else's character. Stop focusing on someone else's life. You don't got no place to be talking about anybody, what you doing, all these rituals here behind the scenes so that people cannot see someone in their truth. Okay? Stop lying to yourself. Stop it, Elizabeth. Stop it. Girl, them ancestors is pissed off at you. You need to stop it. You need to cut it, because when they decide to react, I feel like they're doing that already. They're causing mayhem in your life. That's why you're so desperate out here to put something to an end so that something can be given to you. It's the end for you. This chapter is over. I know you're having a hard time accepting that, but it's over. It's over now. I know you feel like you cannot make it, but you got to talk to your ancestors about that. Oh, wait. They left you there because they said that you are dumb. They can't do this no more. The storm is over now. I guess not. That storm ain't over for you, but whoever you've been coming after, it's over for them. They said you and the rest of the Rugrats and the hooligans can stay over there. But what I'm going to do is stay over here. Mind my business. Because my business pays me. Minding your business don't pay me. Minding my business pays me. That's what that Queen of Pentacles is saying. Anyway, the truth is coming. It's going to help this woman move on with her life and plan more strategically for her life. Step into abundance. Manifest what it is that she wants to manifest in her life, because she has that authority and clearance to do so by the spirit realm. Someone may be even moving away, going to a whole new institution that's going to be working with her equally. They're going to value what it is she brings to the table. You could be coming from that institution and you don't bring nothing of value to that institution as well. This could be two different women that I'm picking up on, but there's something where a Queen of Pentacles is going to end up in an institution where people will want to work with her. They care what she has to say. They may really even value what she has to say more than anyone else, but I don't think this is the kind of person that see things that way. Like, they want everybody to have an input. So it's going to be teamwork when she gets there. It was never teamwork when this heifer here was there, right? So this is going to lead to wish fulfillment for everybody in this institution, because one, you not only know what it is that you do, you actually care. There is something about inspiration and someone caring about what it is that they do. This woman does not care about what it is that she does. Someone does not operate on principles. Someone does not operate on morals, ethics, nothing. No passion, nothing. It brought her a lot of money, and that's all that matters to her. She didn't have the gifts, been going and doing witchcraft with someone else behind the scenes to make sure things go in her favor. I need to do glamour spells. I need to do mental spells. Word spells, everything she does, there's a spell work for it. There's some type of a ritual for it. Okay? And this is why these people, they're finding out the truth now. They said, God dang, all these years we've been working with Elizabeth. Are you trying to tell me Elizabeth never knew nothing, never cared about anything? Elizabeth knew a little, but she knew a little enough what to get her by. She said, you know what? I know A, B, C, D, E, F, G, whatever else come after that obviously is irrelevant, because I've been able to get by with A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So anything else that comes after that is irrelevant. We don't care about it. Elizabeth don't figure out a formula. But now it's got to a point where they want to know. Elizabeth, darling, what comes after G? Oop, crickets. She don't know. Okay? Because Elizabeth has been out here stealing from other people. This is the kind of woman that steals from other people. And while when she's done stealing from you, she'll block you. Block your work, talk negatively about you, may even tell people that you stole from her. The whole time, she's the one that's been out here mirroring your energy, but she can't get it right. Can't get it right, so she's at some type of blockage, some type of stalemate. Girl, it's been a long road for you, ain't it? You had a lot of success taking people down. I think you effed up with one person that you could not take down, and it was never meant for you to take them down. It's not because they did on any type of voodoo, because I think you keep coming out here telling people that there's a woman, this Queen of Pentacles. You keep telling them that she's into voodoo, she's into this, she's into that. You see this woman, right? What do you see here? Manifestation. This is someone that manifests in the upright. That means that they invest in what it is that they want. They actually put in the work. They actually put in the effort to learn the skills that they want in life. They need to get to where it is they need to be. So all these lies you've been telling, it ain't going nowhere. The gig is up. I'm being told to tell you the gig is up. The gag is the gig is up. You don't know it. Everybody else does. So you can keep leaving your community to go and gossip and spread lies about someone's offer. Talking about they gave me the offer, so we don't got to worry about her anymore. They didn't give you no offer. You lying to yourself. You're lying to yourself. Them people don't want to be bothered with you. You about to be part of a whole institution, about to be let go by a masculine. You say, I can't do this anymore, Elizabeth. I can't do this anymore. What is wrong with you? We've been trying to make it work, but you're just not getting it. We didn't know you were doing all of this behind the scenes. We like to do things the right way, Elizabeth. We don't like to steal. We don't want to pretend. We actually care about what it is that we do. We're just over it. Enough is enough. Is that what they told you, Elizabeth? It's the end of the road. Elizabeth, it's the end of the road. The gig is up. The gag is the gig is up, sister. Give it up. I just heard this woman. This is someone that was possibly paying people in some type of institution, because there's, at some point you were supposed to be in an institution working with this creature. And she more than likely paid people so that when you got to that institution, they would reject you. They would say, oh, I don't want to work with her. She's difficult to work with. She don't know what she's doing. If you're a guy, you know, take it as it applies. She don't know. He don't know what it is he's doing, she's doing. Okay. They said this to me. They said this about me. This is like you enter a company on day one. People are rolling their eyes, looking you up in the bombastic side eye. And you basically say, what are you doing here? We know you don't have the qualifications to be in this building, because Elizabeth told us so. And then you're looking at, well, how does Elizabeth know what it is that I know? Oh, that's because Elizabeth don't went and paid someone. Get this. Elizabeth don't went and paid someone to look into you, to find things out about you. Couldn't find anything legit. So Elizabeth and her partner, her boy toy, started making up lies. Her little puppet. Because that's what he is. He's a puppet for her. So this is how Elizabeth is spreading rumors about you and paying people behind the scenes so that they can reject you when you arrive at that institution. Okay? You see the difference here? You went from being out in the cold, outside of an institution, which means you were probably working for an institution that didn't know your value. They didn't know what you brought to the table. They rejected you, left you out in the cold. And then you land into an institution where you are inside and you are on a pedestal. They're coming to you to ask you for answers and information because they know you've put in the work to acquire what it is that you are doing to perfect your skills, that you are someone that cherishes other people's input. You work with people as a team. Elizabeth is threatened. Let me tell you all about Elizabeth, because I think there is someone from Elizabeth's team, a camp that watches tarot, so this could be like a spiritual thing. Elizabeth has never invested in her knowledge, in her education. I don't know if you all paid for Elizabeth to go to school, or Elizabeth told you all she was going to school, or she had some type of degree or whatever. Elizabeth did not learn what she needed to learn to be able to work this position. It's always been her looks that she depended on. May have slept with half of the people in that institution or in that field so that they can support her. Elizabeth is more than likely the person that dresses real skimpy. You just gotta tip your head and you can see her woo-ha under there. Elizabeth has very little self-esteem and she don't care about it. There are certain people that you see that have low self-esteem, and you know they are genuine and they just don't know themselves. But Elizabeth does not care about things like that. Elizabeth is unhinged. Elizabeth has a mental illness. Elizabeth is a psychopath, sociopath, narcissist together. Four things that makes her dangerous. And maybe you already know before. But Elizabeth does not care about improving herself. Elizabeth does not care about being a better person, seeing things from different perspective, a higher perspective, self-actualizing. All of that does not matter to her. It bothers her. Healing bothers her. So I don't know if you all have been tolerating Elizabeth for a long time and acting like, you know, you didn't know what it is she was doing, or maybe whatever method of operation Elizabeth was doing was bringing in money, but it was not really fulfilling. There's an emperor within this community that may be sick and tired of Elizabeth's shenanigans. Elizabeth, baby, it's about to be balanced out for you. You're going to have to figure it out. You're going to have to figure it out. Because I guarantee you, when you and this Queen of Pentacles end up in the same room, you're going to hit yourself. Because if you try that nonsense that you did with everybody else, because this is the person, when you are around them, they will try to talk down to you, but they'll try to do it in a sneaky way. You try that on that Queen of Pentacles, she's going to humble you in 0.3 seconds and you will never fix your mouth again. Because more than likely, this woman don't receive the truth about you with this devil out here followed by the Ace of Swords. A sister don't receive the truth about you a long, long time ago before you and her ever met. So when she arrives at this, when she arrives at this institution and you are still there, you best behave yourself, because she is going to fix you real quick. And she'll do it diplomatically too. Just like, you know, you tear people down in subtle ways, she'll do it in a subtle way, but it's going to hit you hard because someone has received the truth about who you are, who you pretend to be, and who you really are. So don't try it when you meet this Queen of Pentacles. I'm telling you, she's going to humble you. She is going to humble you. Don't try it, Elizabeth. If you're still there when she gets there, don't try it. Baby, don't try it. I'm telling you, some of these people, the ones that don't already took the time to self-actualize and things like that, and they've healed. Oh, Elizabeth, you is going to be effing up if you try this woman. That's all I'm telling you. There's a sister out here that don't got nothing to lose, but she's very tactful and diplomatic on how she handles things. And baby, she's ready for your nonsense. You're out here all vain talking about, I'm pretty. You're dumb as heck, because the field you're in don't got nothing to do with being pretty as heck. The person that's with you, I don't think they were with you for your beauty. So I don't know if this is a thing where you two work together. Work in passion, it just didn't work out. It don't got to do with your beauty. It has to do with your passion, your mindset, your heart space. That's what it has to do with what the Queen of Pentacles possess. The Queen of Pentacles is someone that's very beautiful, someone very nurturing, someone very practical, down to earth, business minded, business savvy. You, because you're in the reverse, with the devil, the seven of wands reversed above you, baby, you are not the Queen of Wands in the upright. If you were, you would be someone that's very charismatic, very hardworking, very committal, very loyal. You ain't none of those things. Even the people you got to collaborate with you against a total stranger, you are not loyal to them. You don't probably did things to these people behind the scenes that they are not aware of. So anyways, that's enough of Elizabeth's secrets coming out today. I will see you all in my next read. Thank you for watching and goodbye for now.